Flumazenil acts as an antidote. Flumazenil is a relative of the benzodiazepine, and we can find the structure of Flumazenil as like this. And let us start the numbering here. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And here the structure is somewhat similar to the benzodiazepine, and we can observe that the 1,4 benzodiazepine is fused with the imidazole ring. So it is having a one of the nucleus, imidazolobenzodiazepine. And it's also having the 8th position electron withdrawing group like the fluorine. But one of the important difference with the benzodiazepines is that the benzodiazepines are having the 6th position phenyl group, but here it is having the 6 keto group. In this way, flumazenil is a structural relative of the benzodiazepine, but it acts as an antagonist, where benzodiazepines act as agonists. So that's why flumazenil can be used as an antidote for the benzodiazepines. Suppose this is the GABA A receptors. On the GABA A receptors, benzodiazepine A receptors are present, which are in equilibrium with the another conformation, benzodiazepine B receptors. Now both are in the equilibrium such that the GABA A receptors may be expressed with any of these two conformations. Now benzodiazepines can act on the benzodiazepine A receptors, thereby they increase the action of the GABA on the GABA A receptors, which increases the anxiolytic effect. So when the benzodiazepines bind to the benzodiazepine A conformation, they decrease the anxiety and they increase the sedation. And benzodiazepines does not act on the benzodiazepine B conformation, but few of the chemicals like the beta carbolines can bind to this benzodiazepine B conformation, thereby they increase the anxiety. You can observe that benzodiazepine A conformation is going to decrease the anxiety, whereas benzodiazepine B conformation is going to increase the anxiety. And benzodiazepines mainly acting on the benzodiazepine A conformation, but few of the compounds like the beta carbolines only act on the benzodiazepine B conformation. So that's why benzodiazepines are acting as agonists on the benzodiazepine receptors, whereas beta carbolines are going to act as inverse agonists, because once they bond, they increase the anxiety, they produce the opposite effect to the whatever the agonists they are going to produce. So that's why they're called inverse agonists. Now the flumazenil, which is an antidote for this benzodiazepines, can block this benzodiazepine A conformation, thereby they inhibit the benzodiazepine related actions. At the same time, flumazenil can also block the benzodiazepine B conformation. So that's why flumazenil is a real antagonist for the benzodiazepine receptors. So it can block both benzodiazepine A conformation as well as benzodiazepine B conformation. How it is used? So flumazenil is used as an antidote for the benzodiazepines, and it is given as an injection by intravenous route. And the dose, because it is given as an intravenous route, the dose is given initially as 0.2 mg. So whenever 0.2 mg injection is given, if sedation is controlled within 30 seconds, it can be continued. Otherwise, a next dose of the flumazenil can be given to control the sedation. Where it is used? So flumazenil acts as an antidote for the benzodiazepine. So it can be used for all the situations related with the benzodiazepine actions. So one of the important use of flumazenil is to reverse the sedation caused by the benzodiazepine. So it is used to control the sedation and to reverse the sedation that is caused by the benzodiazepines. And similarly, it can also be used to control the anesthesia caused by the benzodiazepines. So only one of the benzodiazepine which is used as an IV anesthetic is the midazolam. So midazolam is produced anesthesia, and if its anesthesia is more, the patient may lose the consciousness and the patient may be more sedative in nature. In such situation, benzodiazepine's action can be terminated by flumazenil. And flumazenil can also be given with the benzodiazepine overdoses. Whenever the benzodiazepines are given at a overdose, the sedation and other CNS depressant effects of the benzodiazepines can be reversed by flumazenil. So now benzodiazepine going to act on the benzodiazepine A receptors as an agonist, and flumazenil is going to block these benzodiazepine A receptors as an antagonist. So flumazenil is a competitive in nature, so it is going to be bind to the same binding site where the benzodiazepines are also going to bind. Benzodiazepines increase the sedation, and flumazenil being an antagonist, it decreases the sedation. Similarly, benzodiazepines are going to decrease the convulsions, so they can be used as the anti-convulsant agent. For example, diazepam, clonazepam, they can be used as the anti-convulsants. But flumazenil, because again acting like an antagonist, it may increase the convulsions. So this is very important point to note, that flumazenil can increase the convulsions in the patient. So these increased convulsions may increase the death in the patient if they are not properly controlled. So what are the side effects of flumazenil? Flumazenil produces pain at site of injection. So this is one of the problems. So it is not given directly as an IV injection, but it is mixed with the IV infusions. Then it is going to enter into the arteries, where it instantaneously distributed and produces its effect on controlling the sedation. And other side effects of the flumazenil include anxiety, tremor, palpitations, insomnia, and convulsions. You can observe that all these symptoms are just the reverse of the actions of the benzodiazepine. So benzodiazepine reversal effects are produced by flumazenil, because flumazenil acts as an antagonist to the benzodiazepine receptors. What are the limitations? So one of the important limitations of this flumazenil is the short-term control of sedation. So when the flumazenil injection is given, it can work maximum for 2 hours in the patients. So after the 2 hours, if the sedation is reappeared, again flumazenil dose should be given. An important limitation of the flumazenil is the risk of convulsions. Already we have seen that flumazenil acts as an antagonist to the benzodiazepine receptors, which normally decrease the convulsions. So when the flumazenil is used, it may increase the risk of convulsions. So any patients who are already having the risk factors for the convulsions, the flumazenil may increase the convulsions and even death of the patient. And again, another limitation is the tachycardia. So if a patient is having cardiovascular problems, the flumazenil can increase the tachycardia. So whenever the flumazenil is given, the risk factors for the flumazenil use, such as convulsions and cardiovascular problems, should be thoroughly checked in order to prevent the death of the patient. So if it is properly used, flumazenil acts as an immediate antidote to reverse the benzodiazepine actions. So it is particularly used to reverse the sedation as well as anesthesia produced by the benzodiazepines. And whenever benzodiazepines are accidentally consumed at an overdose, again the flumazenil can be given. But it is given as an IV route, and it is mixed with the IV infusions to reduce the pain at the site of injection. So that's about the flumazenil, which acts as an antidote for benzodiazepines.